Hello and welcome to Rajya Sabha News on Rajya Sabha Television with me, Frank Pereira. Here are the headlines. Rajya Sabha sits beyond stipulated time of 6 p.m. to discuss union budget. Congress leader P. Chidambaram poses 12 questions on economic and fiscal management. BJP's Bhupendra Yadav says government's policy is designed to benefit all vulnerable sections. From agrarian crisis to job creation, opposition members from Samajwadi Party, CPIM, BSP and Trinamool Congress questioned the government on several aspects of the budget. An upper house witnesses protests over the issue of special status to Andhra Pradesh. Members from Andhra Pradesh and Telangana demand urgent solution to the crisis. The upper house discussed the union budget 2018-19 on Thursday. The discussion was initiated by Congress member P. Chidambaram. Members across political spectrum participated in the discussion. Here are the details.
Initiating the discussion, Congress leader P. Chidambaram posed 12 questions on the union budget presented by the NDA government. He accused the government of abandoning fiscal prudence.
In 2016-17, when India's GDP, according to your number, has fallen to 7.1%, the increase in number is 75 lakhs. Worse, for 2017-18, when you admit India's GDP is falling further to 6.5%, you are claiming 70 lakhs jobs have been created. This must be the only country in the world where GDP falls but employment increases.
Delivering a sharp rebuttal, BJP's Bhupendra Yadav said there was policy paralysis during the UPA rule and accused the Congress of misusing constitutional institutions. He also said the NDA government has plugged leakages in the delivery of subsidies and is removing corruption.
जब भी आप अपनी कोई योजना बनाओ तो अपने मन में सबसे अंतिम छोर पर बैठे हुए व्यक्ति के चित्र का ध्यान करना वो योजना बनाना और मैं गर्व के साथ प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र भाई मोदी जी के नेतृत्व में जो भी योजना हमारी सरकार की बनी है वो हमेशा देश के गरीब आदमी के चेहरे को देखकर ध्यान में रखी है आप उस पे किसी प्रकार की टीका टिप्पणी कर सकते हैं लेकिन देश के गरीब का आर्थिक सशक्तिकरण और देश के हर वर्ग का सामाजिक समायोजन करने के लिए जो हमारी सरकार प्रतिबद्ध है आप उसको रोक नहीं सकते
The finance minister is slated to give a detailed reply on the discussion on Friday. Kriti Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, during the discussion, other members, including members from Samajwadi Party, CPIM, BSP and Trinamool Congress, also questioned the government on several issues.
Chahe Vidarbh ho, chahe Bundelkhand ho. Bundelkhand ke humare halat dekhiye jaakar maaniye Vitt Mantri ji. Aaj wahan ka kisan tabah hai, mar raha hai. Wahan fasal sukh gayi hai. वर्षा आधारित खेती है वहां के लोग पलायन कर रहे हैं रोजगार के लिए बाहर पलायन कर रहे हैं आज किसी को उपज का जो उनकी लागत मूल्य नहीं है घाटे की खेती का आत्महत्या हो रही मानव
द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैड रिड्यूस्ड इट्स शेयर ऑफ द सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम्स फ्रॉम 75% टू 60% दिस वाज डन बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया यूनिलैटरली ऑन द प्रेटेक्स्ट दैट स्टेट्स हैड ऑब्टेन्ड एडिशनल फिस्कल स्पेस due to the increase in the devolutions to states from 32 to 42%. Unfortunately, states like Tamil Nadu have suffered badly due to the 14th Finance Commission's recommendations.
Finance Minister, mission is strengthen agriculture, kishans, health, education, employment, MSME and infrastructure. Where is the money? Where from it will come, from the sky or from other countries at donation. It is not reflected properly. It is not explained.
14th Finance Commission ki siparis ke aadhar par central taxes mein rajyon ke share 32% se badhakar 42% kiya gaya hai. Ye achhi baat hai, lekin iske baad kai sare central scheme का जो शेयरिंग पैटर्न भी बदल दिया गया है जिससे राज्यों को काफी दिक्कत आ रही है राज्यों को काफी बोझ पड़ रहा है
2014 में सत्ता में आने के बाद इस सरकार ने पहली बार ब्लैक मनी के खिलाफ बैंक लुटेरे सफेदपोशों के खिलाफ ठोस कार्रवाई की। 8 ठोस कदम उठाए, समय होता तो मैं आपको सुनाता, कानून बनाने से लेकर नीति बनाने तक। 1970 के बाद बनी 40 कमेटियों को रिपोर्ट के बाद जो सफाई नहीं हुई उसकी शुरुआत हुई है।
रूरल डेवलपमेंट एज ए परसेंटेज ऑफ GDP इज रिड्यूस फ्रॉम 1.15% टू 1.08%। हेल्थ एक्सपेंडिचर हैज फॉलन फ्रॉम 0.32% टू 0.29%। सेंट्रल एक्सपेंडिचर ऑन एजुकेशन, अगेन वन प्रायोरिटी एरिया स्पोकन इन योर बजट स्पीच, एजुकेशन हैज फॉलन फ्रॉम 0.49% टू 0.29%।
किसानों की ये स्थिति है कि उसको उसके फसल का समर्थन मूल्य भी नहीं मिल रहा है, उसका कर्ज जो माफ करने की बात चल रही थी वो माफ भी नहीं हुआ।
ओवर द लास्ट 4 years GDP हैज ग्रोन, पर कैपिटा इनकम हैज इंक्रीज्ड, FDI फ्लोज ऑफ द लास्ट 3 years हैव स्टेडीली इंक्रीज्ड, विद 2016-17 रिकॉर्डिंग 60 billion, फॉरेन एक्सचेंज रिजर्व्स हैव क्रॉस्ड 400 billion, inflation has moderated and government finances are following a roadmap of fiscal discipline after years of reckless profligacy.
I'm glad this finance minister has woken up to the MSP reality and has abandoned the theology that higher MSP means higher inflation. Higher MSP leads to rural prosperity. Of course, you have to assure that the MSP is actually received by all the farmers. Announcing MSP is one thing and farmers getting MSP is another.
Desh ke agriculture se infrastructure tak pura dhyan diya gaya hai. Agar budget mein garib aur madhyam varg ki chinta dur karne wali baatein hain to is aur unke health ke liye baatein hain to chote udyamiyon ke liye wealth badhane wali yojnaye bhi hain.
Well, earlier, the Rajya Sabha was adjourned till 2 p.m. in the afternoon. The House had agreed to suspend question hour to take up discussion on the union budget. But then TDP and YSR Congress MPs raised the issue of special package for Andhra Pradesh. After this, the chairman decided to adjourn the House. Earlier, the House also adjourned once till 12 noon after Congress MPs raised various issues.
If government is willing, there are some issues of special category status, bridging of the resource gap, capital development, all these things are the steel plant that the finance minister, while addressing the budget speech, they can commit to resolve these issues within 15 days, sir.
So if they are not adhered to, if they are not followed, and if this house is incapable of protecting the rights of our own words, acts, sir, What for this constitution has constituted this house?
Well, Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu also welcomed the members of a parliamentary delegation from the Republic of Chile who witnessed the proceedings from the box.
Members, we have with us, situated in the special box, members of parliamentary delegation from the Republic of Chile. Currently on a visit to our country under the distinguished leadership of His Excellency Mr. Fidel Espinosa, President of the Chamber of Deputies of the Republic of Chile. On behalf of the members of the House and on my own behalf, I take pleasure in extending a hearty welcome to the leader and other members of the delegation and wish our distinguished guests an enjoyable and fruitful stay in our country. We hope that during their stay here, they would be able to see and learn more about our parliamentary system, our country, and our people, and that their visit will further strengthen the friendly bonds that exist between India and the Republic of Chile. Through them, we convey our greetings and best wishes to the Parliament and also the friendly people of Republic of Chile.
Well, the Rajya Sabha today made obituary reference to the passing away of Frida Topno, a former member of the upper house.
Honourable members, I refer with profound sorrow to the passing away of Ms. Frida Topno, a former member of this House, on the 6th of February 2018 at the age of 92 years. Born in September 1925 at Sundargarh district of Odisha, Ms. Topno was educated at the Women's College and the Radhanath Training College, Cuttack, Odisha. A social and political worker, Ms. Topno worked for the preservation and promotion of tribal culture, women's education, welfare of scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. She established a Priyadarshini Mahila Mahavidyalaya at Rourkela. She had a few publications to her credit. Ms. Topno started her legislative career as a member of the Odisha Legislative Assembly from 1985 to 1990 and served as a Minister of State for Fisheries and Animal Husbandry from 1985 to 1986 and for Education, Youth Services and Sports from 1986 to 1990 in the Government of Orissa. She was also a member of the 10th and 11th Lok Sabha. Ms. Frida Topno represented the state of Odisha in this house April 1998 to April 2002. In the passing away of Ms. Frida Topno, the country has lost a distinguished parliamentarian and a dedicated social worker. We deeply mourn the passing away of Ms. Frida Topno. I request the members to raise in their places and observe silence as a mark of respect to the memory of the departed. Santi.
Well, with that, it's a wrap on this newscast. Good night.